Hi everyone, and welcome to the next lesson, which will be on Django models and databases. All right, so let's get straight to it. All right, so let's go to our project here. And I just want to show you something first. So head over to your project and then go to settings.py. And I just wanted to scroll down a bit here and reacquaint ourselves with something here. So if you recall from, I believe it was the first video, where I just briefly went over the settings.py file and just quickly mentioned the database is configuration area. So we can see here, this is where we would configure our database. So at the moment, we have a SQLite database, which we can also see the file here, configured. So of course, later in this series on Django Fundamentals, we will be swapping this out for a Postgres database. Okay. So of course, this is where you will select your database engine, whether you're using MySQL, Postgres, SQLite, and so on. So just a bit of helpful advice when you're planning on deploying a project into production mode, it is best to use another database other than SQLite. I would recommend Postgres or MySQL for this purpose. Okay, so that's what I wanted to mention about that. Okay, so next thing that we want to do is, all right, so if your server's running, you can go ahead and just close it down for a moment. What we need to do is rerun our server, and I want to show you something here. So let's rerun it. And once we've run it, you'll see here it says, you have 18 unapplied migrations. Your project may not work until you apply the migrations for apps, admin, auth, content type sessions. Okay, so these are, we have apps here, okay? So if you remember in the previous lectures where I was talking about apps, so if we go to settings.py, we will see that we have apps here that are installed already by Django. Okay, so these are pre-installed apps. So these are not internal apps, they're external apps that have been installed. Okay, so pretty much what we need to be aware of here is that we need to migrate everything here. Okay, we need to make sure that we apply migrations. Okay, so these migrations have files, have pretty much database files, which we need to send to SQLite here. Okay, so just bear that in mind. Okay. So before we move on, there's just one thing that we missed from earlier on. We need to make sure that we add our latest app. Okay, so we know that our app here is to do. Okay, and we need to just add it here to the list of installed apps so that our models and everything here will be working properly. So let's go ahead and do that. Right, so this is very simple. We just look at our app name, so it's to do, and we're just going to install our app here. So we should have technically done this earlier in the app section, but of course, I figured this will be a good time to put it in. Okay, so now we can we can apply these migrations. So let's go and type in the following. So Python manage .py, and you want to just say migrate. Okay, so this will migrate all those default database files, all those migrations to our SQLite database. So we need to say migrate. And we can see they've been migrated and everything's working. So let's run our server to make sure everything's okay and that there's nothing's broken and everything's perfect. So we can double check by just refreshing. Yeah, we're good. Okay, so that was, of course, migrating our initial migrations. Okay, so what we want to do now is we want to look at Django models. All right, so let's go to do. And we have our models.py file here. Right, so we're in our models.py file here. And what we're going to do is go ahead and create a Django model. So of course, I'll explain it after we've created it in full detail so it makes sense. So first thing we need to do is we need to create a class, okay? So I'm going to give it a name here. So I'm going to say class task, okay? And then in parentheses, I'm going to inherit Django models here. So very straightforward, we're just going to say models.model, just like that. Make sure that the M here is capital. And now we need to state some attributes that we want to be a part of our Django model. So for example, I'm going to say title equals models dot, and we're going to say actually char field, yeah. And then in that char field, we're going to say set a max length of about 85 characters. Okay, so basically here we have an attribute that we're defining, which is given the name title. And we want the data sort of type to be of a char field. So this is like a text field, but much smaller per se. Okay, then the next thing that we want to do is we want to create another attribute, and we're going to call this content. And we can just say models.charField again, because we want text to be entered in this data, in this field here. So the data type is of a string, so text. And I want to set the max length here to about 300 characters. So that's the max character someone would be able to type in that field. And the next thing we want to do is I want to create one more called date posted. Okay, and I'm going to say models.dateTime field, auto, now, and then add, and I'm going to say true. Okay, so basically this last attribute here, which is date posted, pretty much is going to say whenever we create another record or an object with this task model, okay, it's going to just post a date each time that we post an object or a record, every time. And it's going to do it automatically because I set the parameter here, auto now add is true. So it's automatically going to add the date and time every time we create a record using this model. Okay, so the way that I want us to understand a model is basically like we have our attributes, so title, content, and date posted, and we have our name of our model. So kind of treat it like a database table. So we are pretty much creating a database table where our database table's name is task, and the attributes of that database table includes title, content, and date posted. Now you're probably wondering, what about ID? We didn't specify ID, but that's the great thing about Django Models. It automatically, on its own, Django Models already assigns an ID and takes care of that for us, so we don't need to worry about that. So with Django Models, I just want you to kind of see it as like a database sort of table with attributes that we define here, title, content, and date posted. And for example, char field and date time field here, these are our, you could say, data types. So this is the format that the data will be stored under. So char field will have text and string, and date time field, of course, will be a date time. And since we set it automatically. And of course, with max length here, this is the maximum number of characters that can be in one record, per record created. Okay. So that is how we create a Django model. Okay, so the next thing we need to do is we need to migrate this model to the database. So let's do just that. So we can close this here. And what I want us to do is to simply just say Python manage.py. And before we can migrate to a database, you'll notice we have a migrations folder here. Now, there are two things we need to do. The first thing we need to do is sort of prepare our model before we migrate it to the database. So pretty much organize everything and get the structure set. And to do that sort of preparation, we need to say make migration. So every time you create a new model, you need to run the Python manage.py make migrations command. So pretty much this is kind of like a preparation for the database. So in other words, for example, like on GitHub, where you push your latest change and then you commit. So this is kind of like the same situation here. So we're making our migration, so we're pushing it, and then our commit is our migrate. Okay, so that's one way to understand it. So make our migrations, and you'll see here in the directory in our to-do app here under migration 001 initial.py, Django created a model for us called task, with the name here, and it's under this migrations folder, and we can see it here. So this is what's going to be prepared to be sent to our MySQL database, and you can see it. Django automatically adds the ID field for us, the title, the content, and date posted. So like I said, try and envision this as sort of like a database sort of table, with the name being task and the attributes ID, title, content, and date posted. So if we go back, that's good. Now we have one more thing to do. Now we need to actually send it to SQLite here. So we need to actually send it to our database. And to do that, we can just simply say migrate. Okay, there we go. So you'll see here, it'll apply all migrations to everything that we currently have here, all our apps. So admin, auth, content type, sessions, and to do. And then it runs the migrations for what needs to be migrated. And here we had to-dos models.py that needed to be migrated. And it just simply applied the migration. And if it says initial OK, that means our model has been migrated. And that is it. That's perfectly how it works. So now, OK, I've showed you a little bit about Django models. I've also explained a little bit about databases and so on. And of course, in the next lecture, we'll be looking at Django admin, and we will also be looking at how to register our models so we can actually see it in admin.py. All right, so that's it.